When did you begin working on the new album?
I'm sort of have to explain about that.
Yeah.
I'm doing this thing with a internet record company called Artistshare. And they, okay, so their whole system works that as an artist, I start a project, and within a course of a year, you know, people who are interested in this project can log on to my website, and they can sort of basically pre-buy the album, exactly, and through the course of the year, see the album come to life, you know, through a series of blogs, if I have a rehearsal or a tour during that time in which I'm performing the new songs, then, you know, it might be a streaming audio or a video or, you know, and stuff like that. And just sort of basically, you know, my demos, the charts, you know, as I scribble them along and the inspirations behind the songs or, you know, whatnot. So it's sort of an interesting concept. And the reason they came up with this, Artistshare, this concept or their system, is because, you know, since basically the end of the 20th century with all the softwares and all the, you know, downloading and file sharing, it's become more and more a thing where CDs aren't selling as much. And, you know, and for musicians, it's not just the record companies and the CD, you know, shops or whatnot that are suffering, but it's also, it generally ends up affecting the artists in that, you know, we make royalties out of this stuff, and if we aren't showing to the record companies that we're able to sell records, and they drop us like hot potatoes, you know, and then they end up going for artists that are going to be more commercial, and it's just a regurgitation of marketable music rather than, you know, artful music, which is what I'm personally more interested in doing.
Yeah.
And I think most artists really are more interested in doing music that's more of a pure reflection of themselves rather than to try and go for the big bucks, you know. So, I don't know, maybe they're going for the big bucks, who knows. But anyhow, so it was, I went with Artistshare because it was sort of my way to be able to keep control artistically of what I wanted to do.
Yeah.
So with that said, this new project, which at the time the project name was Flow, was released in March of 2007.
Mm-hmm.
And throughout the course of the year, I slowly developed the ideas and concept of what I wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
That concept did change as time went on, as anything will happen. You know, like I had an image in my mind that I was going to have a bunch of, you know, different producers have their hand at helping to form the music, and I was thinking of it being a stream of music that went from one song to the next, where, you know, from one song the next producer would pick up, you know, where that left off, and then continue on that vein, and then you know, go into the next piece of music and so on. But it didn't quite work out that way because I didn't get myself together to write the music early enough, you know. So by the time I hit everyone, it was like, oh, the deadline's too crazy. So I do have three different producers who are, you know, who did take a crack at it, and I just ended up sort of streaming everything together myself, you know. But
did a bit more work than you usually would then.
What?
You did a bit more work than you usually would.
Actually, not really. I did pretty much as much work as I usually do, because I do usually produce all of my tracks, or, you know, once in a while I'll have other people, you know, do stuff with me. So it's sort of just more of the same, I guess.
Yeah.
But different, you know. I think I love the stuff that I wrote this time, and I really feel very strongly about this album. So the album name is Nexus. And it was, again, going into that whole idea of flowing. I was looking up, you know, in the dictionary, like, you know, give me a word. And at first I was thinking continuum. Then I realized, oh, wait a minute, John Mayer came out with an album. Like, I can't do that. All right.
Yeah, that's out the window.
And then Nexus, I just love the feeling of the word. And, you know, I don't know if you guys have in the UK, there's a hair product line called Nexus. I was like, oh, I don't know. It sounds like a hair product line. But it's such a cool word, you know, Nexus.
Yeah.
So that's the name of the
album. Who's working on the album with you? Because I know you usually work with a lot of people.
I do. Musician-wise, I'm working with my core New York-based There's a new drummer that I started working with last year, or rather we just did one live together, and I thought he was very good, and he's working with one of my favorite guitarists, Kurt Rosenwinkel. So I thought I would give him a crack. His name is Obed Calvert. He's I think Haitian, from Haitian roots, young cat, and so he knocked down a few tracks for me. I have on electric bass Fema Efron, on the self-produced stuff, I should say. David Kikoski on keyboards, who's a brilliant player. On wood bass, stand-up bass, I have Boris Kozlov. And my husband, again, takes front seat as the horn arranger and trumpet, flugelhorn.
He's a trumpet player, isn't he?
He is, yes, and he's really brilliant. I mean, all the musicians on here are great, you know. Adam Rogers on guitar, and he produced one of the songs and did such a great job. It's such a great track that he did. It's very warm, and he did all the recording and all the instruments at home in his own studio, and I think he did a beautiful job. I love this track. Kyoto Jazz Massive is also producing one of the tracks, and you know, they put their stamp on one of them. It's you know, it came out very KJM. It sounds really great.
Kyoto Jazz
and,
Massive, that is.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, is that correct?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right, Kyoto Jazz Massive, yeah. The Okino Brothers.
Yeah, I know of them. From
yeah.
Japan.
And, yeah, that's right. And, you know, Okino-san, the older brother, Okino-san, and I go way back, you know, 1993 or so we met, which was when he was still managing Mondo Grosso, and he had just started to record the first Kyoto Jazz Massive album, and he asked me to make a vocal appearance there. So I was really very, you know, complimented that he would ask me, and since then we've had a great working relationship as well as a friendship, you know, and he was also one of my mentors when I first started DJing. He really helped to turn me on to a lot of you know, old
music.
Jazz, you know, soul, funk, really more sort of like that on the jazz vein, but on the soul jazz vein, you know, which was really great to get his take on stuff, and you know. And he really introduced me to a lot of the sort of fusion Brazilian stuff, which was really interesting for me, and I took a lot of that in as well, you know. And his brother, you know, the other Okino, who is also a part of Kyoto Jazz Massive, he's got a killing record collection, and you know, every time I would do events or DJ in his club or his events, you know, I would just love hearing his selections. So that, you know, all of that really inspired to help to nurture me and to develop where I'm going musically.
Yeah.
So I'm very indebted to them. I just love them. Yeah. And they're great people, too. They're really great cats, you know.
Yeah. Where's your album available then? Is that correct?
It is now available as a download through my website, and people can also order the CD. That will be it's in pressing right now, so it should be hot off the presses the first week of June. And I do want to mention there's one other cat that I worked with on this on this album, which he produced this track, but he is someone I met through MySpace.
Yes,
and he goes by Soul Phoenix. He's based in Spain.
Mm-hmm.
He's a, you know, fairly young guy, and he hit me one day, and, you know, I checked out his page, and I really liked where he was coming from. He had sort of like a Jamiroquai incognito sort of thing going on, and, you know, and musician-wise and production-wise, he was very tight, and I thought, oh, you know, it would be really cool to do something with him. So he was very open to the idea of trading something, and you know, I honestly had forgotten about him, you know, when it came to time to actually hit people, you know, you want to do something. And he hit me like about a month before I was ready to go into recording.
Yeah.
And it's like, you know, do you still want to do a trade? And I'm like, whoa, well, you got 2 weeks to come up with a track. You want to do it? And he's like, yes.
Yeah.
So in a very short amount of time, we just went back and forth. And he came up, you know, I sent him a track. I was like, what do you think of this? And he was interested. So he dove into it, and I can't tell you how dedicated this guy was and how how great he was to work with. He was a gem. His production is tight.
Yes.
It's one of my favorite tracks on the album. It's got like a real Sergio Mendes incognito sort of thing going on, you know? And it would be my honor if people in Japan hear this record and say, hey, who's this guy? And, you know, maybe some artist is going to go, man, I really like what he did on Monday's record, and I want to use him.
Yeah.
That would be great. You know, that would be for me like my repaying him in some way that he did such hard work on this. And then if that leads, you know, doors opening for him, then
it's a positive
that's great.
Yeah.
So.